Today, I want to talk about what is possibly the most underrated tool in Affinity Photo. This tool is ignored by thousands of users, but it's extremely powerful. And when I tell you what it is, you're probably going to stop watching because it's considered boring. Don't make that mistake. Keep watching because you're going to learn some new things about the Move tool that make it extremely powerful. Let me show you a simple example. If you look at the Layer Studio panel of this image, you can see that there's only one layer in the image. Now let's select the Move tool from the Tools palette. We then get this blue box around the edge of the layer. And if you look at the corners and along the edges, you can see these blue crosses. These are grab handles or resizing handles that we can use with the Move tool. But when I click them, nothing happens. That's because this layer is locked. Again, if we go back to the Layer Studio panel, you can see a small padlock icon on the layer. Click this once to remove the lock. Now I can click and drag the image with the Move tool to reposition it. Also, the grab handles have become circles rather than crosses. This allows us to click and drag them to resize the image. When I use the corner handles, it resizes the image, keeping the height and width in proportion. But if I use one of the handles along the edges, it only changes the height or width. This allows me to create a different perspective for my image. But there's much more I can do. I can also use modifier keys on my keyboard to change the Move tool's behavior. If I hold down the Shift key and then click and drag the bottom edge, it resizes the image from the center line. Then if I hold down my Command key, which is a control key on a PC, it resizes the image equally from the top and bottom edges. Using the same Command key whilst dragging one of the corners resizes the entire image from the center point of the layer. Now whilst I've been doing this, you may have noticed there's a checked pattern appeared around the edge of the image. This tells me that the area is transparent and that there aren't any pixels there. What you're seeing here is the document canvas, which is usually covered by the image because by default it's the same size. But as we've resized the image, but not the document, we can now see the canvas. This allows me to show you another feature when using the Move tool, which is the handle at the top. When I place the Move tool over the handle, you can see that it changes to a curved arrow. Now I can click and drag the handle so that it rotates the image around the center point of the layer. Notice that as I drag, you also see the angle of rotation it creates. Like with the other drag handles on the corners and edges, I can also hold down my Shift key to change the tool's behavior. When I hold down Shift and drag, the image now rotates through 15-degree segments at a time. Now, although I said the handle rotates the image around the center point, that's not entirely true. It's rotating around something we call the origin, and we can move the origin. All we need to do is click the option in the toolbar to enable the transform origin. This means that I can now see the center point for the layer. If I place my mouse over it, you can see it changes to a crossed arrow. Now I can click and drag to move the origin point to a new position on the document canvas. I can even click it and drag it to move it outside of the image area. Now when I rotate the image, you can see that it rotates around the new origin point. If you decide you want to reset the origin, double click the point and it returns to the center of the layer. As with the other features we've looked at, we can change this behavior by holding down a modifier key on the keyboard. When I hold down the Shift key and drag the origin point, it repositions it, rotating it through 45-degree angles. The Command key in this case doesn't change the behavior, but it does allow me to see where the center point of the layer actually is. Another option in the toolbar that you might find useful is to hide the selection while dragging. You'll notice that if I click and drag the layer with the Move tool, we can see the blue outline around it. But when the option to hide the selection when dragging is enabled, the box disappears when I drag. Now let's add a text layer with the text Formby Beach to this image using the Artistic Text tool. Notice that the box around the text looks very much like the box around the image when we were using the Move tool. And here's the interesting thing. It works in exactly the same way as the Move tool, so I can click and drag to resize the text. And if I go back to using the Move tool now rather than the text tool, I can do the same. Now I want you to notice that I can use the Move tool to select either the image layer or the text layer. As I click on each, it selects that layer in the Studio panel. This behavior is determined by the Auto Select drop-down in the Context Sensitive toolbar. When it's set to On or Layer, I can select either of the layers by clicking on their contents in the document area. But when it's set to Off, if I click and drag anywhere else in the document, it moves the active layer rather than selecting a different layer. Then if I want to choose a different layer, I need to actually go and select it in the Layer Studio panel. I've seen people become completely confused by this one setting, so it's well worth knowing and understanding it. Now because I've been moving these two layers around, they're no longer in the center of the frame. This is where the alignment icons in the toolbar come in useful. If I select a layer, I can move it to the center, left or right of the document area, vertically as well as horizontally. Now watch what happens if I select the text layer and choose the Align Left option. It moves the text to the edge of the document. Let's position that in the center now, and then select both the image layer and the text layer. This time when I click the Align Left option, it aligns the text within the area of the image rather than the document. If you find yourself compositing images using multiple layers, these tools are invaluable. But there's something else that you need to know. When I select the text layer using the Move tool, we now see the different text options appear in the toolbar. These allow me to easily change things like the color, font, size, and weight without needing to go back to the Artistic Text tool. But there's also something more that's extremely powerful and hidden in the toolbar, which is this curves button. Watch what happens when I click it. It separates the text into individual letters. Over in the Layer Studio panel, you can see that the text layer has been converted into a group. And now, each of the letters which made up the text is on a separate layer in that group. If I select one of the layers, you'll see that the Node tool becomes enabled in the Tools palette, which allows me to do something very special. If you want to know what that is, you need to watch this video next, where I use this tool to create an artistic watermark. Thanks for watching today, and if you haven't already, don't forget to subscribe. I'll see you soon for another video.